is the size of my canvas, and today is the 8th day of drawing the same painting smaller every day. Well, here we are. I'm still chugging along. This one has just entirely lost all resemblance with the original painting. And for size, I guess it's about the size of an ant.
Oh, it's time
for the 6 fan arts challenge.
Woo.
So far, we've done Garnet and Draco. After looking through your guys' comments and my husband's relentless demands, I have chosen Rapunzel and Hot Squidward.
Yeah.
Oh my God, and on that note, let's start with Rapunzel. I'm thinking a nice storybook style for her should work well. You know, I'm gonna say Rapunzel's definitely one of the cooler Disney princesses. I mean, who doesn't love a girl who can swing through trees and heal bloody wounds with her 50 feet of magic hair?
She'd have a lot of bugs in her hair.
Ew! Alright, let's start Hot Squidward.
Oh yeah.
Okay, so your obsession for this character is starting to scare me a little bit. I'm concerned.
You just don't understand the squid.
What the? You sound like a cult leader.
Don't be hating on Club Squiddy.
Club Squiddy has demanded more chest hair. I think we're ready. We've got our beautiful Disney princess, and we have this.
Yes, squid.
He's a monster.
He's the most beautiful squid in the world.
Who's next?
Finally, part 2 of the guitar that I've been drawing on, and this time we will be working on the backside. To recap, even though I don't do commissions, I decided to take on this project of a longtime supporter and go bonkers on his guitar. This time I decided to switch things up though, and I drew most of the backside on livestream. That encouraged me to work without any breaks throughout the drawing. What I noticed though is that for some reason the backside has seemed to take on different characters and more life objects compared to the front side. For instance, the battleships, pilots, weird creatures, and buildings create a completely different vibe compared to the front. Regardless of the slight style change, I still have found new ways to connect many of the characters. I'm excited to see how this guitar will look when it's put back together, so stay tuned for part 3 where we finish the drawing and we can finally see the final product.
Hey, just call me back when you get this. Now I'm speechless, over the edge, I'm just breathless. I never thought that I'd catch this love bug again.
Thank you. больнице.
О, нет.
Он мент. Теперь все инквизиция.
Маленькая девочка, простите.
Хочешь конфетку?
Нет.
Хочешь конфетку?
Нет.
So I decided that I wanted to decorate my room with Polaroids, but since I don't have a Polaroid camera or Polaroids, I had to make them myself. So I started by picking what size I wanted them to be, and then I used those dimensions to make a template in Adobe Illustrator. And then I exported that template as a PNG with a transparent background. Then once I did that, I opened the PNG in Procreate, and I started inserting the pictures that I wanted to turn into Polaroids. So since I made the PNG have a transparent background, I could use the layers panel to put my picture into the frame of the Polaroid. Then I added a cute caption, and repeated this process for all the other pictures that I was turning into Polaroids. I ended up making 14, and here they all are. So once I was done making all of them, I ordered them as prints from Walgreens Photo. And then once I did that, I left my house for the first time in 4 days to go pick them up. And then I cut them all out, and boom! Polaroids. And it only cost me $1.54.
Can be your sugar when you're feeling for that sweet spot. Put me in your mouth, baby, and eat it till your teeth rot. Can be your cherry, apple, pecan, or your key lime. Baby, I got everything and so much more than she's got.
Oh, no, 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 no. No, 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 no.
They call me Jago. I don't know who's Margo. I just hit this lotto. I'm building up my cargo.
You keep playing where you shouldn't be playing, and you keep thinking that you'll never get burned.
Today I'll be showing you the cheapest method of shipping your commissions. So the first thing you want to do is get rid of the staples. Some of them are going to become damaged. Be careful when you do this because I almost stabbed myself several times. Keep in mind that some of these are going to come out bent because of the way that you took them out, so make sure you tell your client that they need to get their own staples. The edges of the canvas are going to be glued down to the frame, so be careful when you take it off because you might rip it. Next step is to take out the staples that are binding the frame. You can find the frame pieces at Hobby Lobby if you ever need to buy extra ones. Next, I went to Walmart and tried to find the cheapest option for packaging. I found these plastic envelopes. They have bubble wrap in them. Then I got tape and also some tissue paper. I put my piece as flat as possible in between tissue paper. I then used one of the frame pieces to roll it up. I then added more security using the three pieces that were left and rolled it up again. Next, I cut up the envelopes and I combined them like so. Next step is self-explanatory. Because it's so compact, I saved $60 on shipping today.
Okay, so here's my first ever time lapse of this random piece that I did. Right now, I'm just laying down all the colors. Everything's pretty flat, but I'm slowly adding depth, as you can see. Normally, I recommend doing the darker shades first, but I like piling on the highlights like so. And then taking a clean brush and blending it out so it's super, super smooth. And at this point, I kind of realized she kind of looked like Nikki, even though I didn't use a reference for this, but I'm not complaining. And this is the most important part, adding the highlights in the eyes and on the cheekbones because it really makes everything pop. And of course, doing the hair, which was so much fun. I love this texture. Okay, so I'm done with the face. I'm gonna move down to the body. And again, I did not use a reference for this, so just relying on my knowledge of basic human anatomy. All right, and now I'm adding in the background. I'm making it super sketchy so that the focus can be on the person. Yeah, and then some final touches, adding in like a little outline, and we're done.
Thank you. this the last time you leave my body?
Here's a great trick to get highlights out of your gouache. We're gonna use gouache right out the tube and we're gonna go ahead and paint our flat colors. What we wanna do is use water to define the highlights. When our brush is dry and we bring it back to the water, slowly smudging will start to release the paint and reveal the paper white. This will produce highlights. Check out this little mini Mega Man.
Oh!